an infinite eternal life in Christ Jesus. And now, who wants that? Who is telling that? That could be your day of salvation. Don't wait for tomorrow, for tomorrow is not guaranteed. Tomorrow is not promised to you, but today is right now. This moment right now, for anybody under my voice, is guaranteed. Salvation is guaranteed for you. Why? Because you're living right now. Because you're living right now. Nobody knows where they're going to be tomorrow. Only God the Father knows what they believe. Some people go to sleep tonight and they don't know what. You can't die in your sin to be forgiven. You have to come to the Lord for salvation, but you don't have to face the destination of this wicked nation. In God's confirmation that we are all in violation, and this world comes to a violation and eradication. So we can accept the salvation from Jesus and offer him in justification, and he'll take you with him to his heavenly father's creation. Am I right about it? Yeah! That's what you gotta do! That's what you gotta do! Because I am happy all the day knowing that Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior, and knowing that Jesus snatched me from the evil grasp of Satan, opened my eyes and showed me the mistakes I was making. And he can do that for you, and everybody else who's listening. Amen. Am I right about it? No, Scripture says, those who follow me are like those who build their house on a strong foundation. And the mighty winds and waves are not destroyed. But those who don't know me or don't follow me are like those who build their house on dirt and sand, and the wind comes and destroy the house. In other words, when you follow Jesus, your house becomes your vessel, your body. It's got a solid foundation, and when the evil one comes, you cannot play it. But when you don't follow Jesus, you're like that one who lived at a house with a weak foundation. Jesus can come and sweep you off of your feet. But Jesus can make you whole, he'll make you complete. He'll give you the victory. He'll open your eyes so that you can see. No more wandering in darkness. No more despair. Because you already know that Jesus is right here and he'll always be there. Am I right about it? That's why you gotta come to Jesus today, right now, right this minute. And you know, because we don't know where we're gonna be the next half an hour from now. And even if what something does happen to me and my sister right here, we already know our final destination. We have a revelation. We do that when we have an eternal because he gives us the salvation. He gave us eternal life. He took away all of our pain. He took away all of our fight. We don't worry about anything anymore. Take your time out of your day today and ask yourself. That evangelist, there's an evangelist on the corner talking about when Jesus comes. And ask yourself this question. Where am I going to be when Jesus comes? That's all you need to know. Ask yourself that question. Where am I going to be? When I say where you're going to be, where your soul is at right now, where your soul is at. It's not about where you're from, it's not about where you're at. It's about where your soul is when Jesus comes. of Jesus people down here are so mad. Jesus speaks about it, there's so much in the Bible and the Scriptures. You know why he speaks about it so much?
He speaks about it so much because he doesn't want any of us to know it. And he knows the hell is real. And he knows the hell is a terrible place for all of us.
Amen.
And he knows that we can have a stand whatsoever to do these things, because he wants them to give obedience to God since the beginning of time. And so God got fed up with us. He got fed up. And I'm going to be honest with you. If it wasn't for Jesus, none of us would be here right now. This world would have ended a long time ago. Because he didn't know and the flesh and the offer. But no, for God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him may not perish, but have everlasting life. Because Jesus said, I have not come to condemn the world, but to save the world.
Amen.
That's God's message to you right now. That's God's love letter to you, and everybody else under my bed.
That's God's love letter to you.
God's love letter is that Jesus is Son.
Because the promise of Jesus is Son,
that we can have eternal life and have salvation
and be washed by his sin.
Amen.
So you should be getting on your knees right now and thanking God.
Thanking God.
Amen.
And coming to God.
Instead of running from God,
why don't you run to God?
You heard me?
Amen.
So hallelujah to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Good, it's still running. But it's not charged. Now it is.
Hallelujah, good afternoon. People from Eastern Market. I know you've known me a long time.
Long time.
Since 2020.
2020.
When the kingdom, when I received the kingdom of Thailand. Before coronavirus, just a few months, God sent me to fast for 40 days and 40 nights before he gave me the assignment. And I started it. When I was assigned to it, I said, Lord, I can't do it. And God told me, stop. And start that 40 days. And he said, he will be with God. God took me 20 days and 30 nights to a fasting that I never had done before. When it was God, he said, he gave me the kingdom of Simon, and I go everywhere teaching the fire. The fire of the coming of God. God desires everyone to be